live on Diverse FM tonight. It's a 1-1 draw at Cambridge with a last minute equaliser with possibly the only shot on target. It's a point gained. You must be proud of the way your players have battled.
No, absolutely. You know, I said before the game that, you know, we're going to play our side tonight. That this, they may look at this, I'm not saying we would, but they may look at this as their last like throw of the dice to collect. I'm not saying they do, but that's how I felt. And I said, you know, they're going to die to win this game. They're going to die. And we've got to match it. And you know what? I think there was, what, 3 shots all game. I thought we defended terrific. I don't think our attacking play was great, but I didn't think either side's attacking play was great because I thought it was that sort of game. But we just had to work, dig in, and as we know with our team, it's never over. You know, we made some changes. And we got a goal right at the end, and you know we're at the business end of the season coming up. You know, and it's about results. We know we can play great. We know we can attack. We know we can not concede. We know we can score. And today, I think we showed that we know we never beat. So it's another string to our bow.
You've talked about the goal there. I mean, how difficult is it a decision to take off your top scorer who's been on such great form recently?
Wasn't difficult at all. It just wasn't going for him. Just one of them things, you know. It wasn't going for Andre. Happens, you know. It's just, you know, with greatest respect, I never look at, you know, I ain't got no stars. They're in the sky. I've just got hungry players that are competing for a place. It wasn't working for Andre. It doesn't mean to say Andre didn't do his bit for the team, because he did. But it was time to make a change. You know, I know Mark Cullen's a good player. We all know Mark Cullen's a good player, and he'd be very unfortunate not to be in a team. And it was just a change, you know. We took a chance playing Pelly. Pelly's problem with his ankle, but we took a chance with that. He played a little bit longer than perhaps we would have done. The other thing that I'm also aware of is that we go 90 minutes. The team goes 90 minutes. And I actually think the last 15 minutes we got an ascendancy in the game. We got, I thought, lots of crosses in without being great crosses, I'm being honest. But we had the ascendancy, and I just felt that, you know, Cully's a different sort of player. He's a clever player, he's a bright player. Andre's pace and power player. And it just gives them another problem, if you like. You know, it's just another problem. Just to say, just made a couple of changes, but Parry on to give us a little bit of, I don't know, someone who's going to defend our third of the pitch and allow our two wide people. Matty Robinson's got great legs. Alex Lawless can get up and down. So we just felt with Cameron and Parry, we'd just perhaps sit and hold and allow us to attack with a front four as opposed to a front two supported by a wide two. And it's easy to say, yeah, that'll work, because it might not have worked. But at the end of the day, we've scored at the end. Which takes me back to 2007, when Dagenham and Redbridge got promotion. We were away about this time of year to Oxford. We were 1-0 up. Our goalkeeper made a mistake. We ended up 2-1 down. It gave them the ascendancy, and we scored the last kick of the game and for 2-2, which was a fantastic result for us. And you know, forget where we are in the league, forget where Cambridge are in the league. 1-1 here. 1-1 here is a great result, regardless of where we are. They're a former football league club. They're a good club. They have a good manager. They have a good setup. They have great support. We've come from a goal down to equalise. So I'm quite proud of it.
And a word for your goal scorer. He's not had a lot of game time recently. It wasn't the easiest of chances, but
great goal.
He tucked
great
it away.
Finish. Great finish. But, you know, it's really tough, you know. I've always said all along, if there's one player here that, you know, could look at being unfortunate, it was Cully, because he was our leading scorer at one time. He had a slight ankle injury. Andre, who hadn't started great, come in, picked it up. And it was hard to change, and it's been hard to change, of course. He's the league's leading goal scorer. And I think today, you know, we've used the full strength of our squad, really. And, you know, really pleased with, you know, pleased for them.
and a great time to equalise. But it, almost, you know, Luton, as you said, had played the last 15 minutes so well, it was almost chances for a winner in injury time.
No, it was, yeah. And, you know, I think you notice, other than Benno did once, he ran it in the corner. We didn't run it in the corner. You know, we tried to win it. And I think that's how we, you know, we'd like to have won it. But, you know, I think it was a fair result and a good result for us.
And finally, a word on the fans. We talk about them a lot, but over 2,200 for a big game in the
2,201, I counted them all. listen, you know, I go back to that early part of the season when I said about team, about everybody has to do their bit. Well, I can tell you now that that 2,200 and the ones that were here in spirit got us that point because they stayed behind the team non-stop. That last 10-15 minutes, they raised the volume, never stopped going, never stopped getting behind the team. And when I look in the paper tomorrow, if it gives a name, the scorer, Cullen, in brackets, it will go plus 2,200 supporters.